Alan Carpenter stumbled across the work of a little-known mathematician named Benoit Mandelbrot.
In 1978, I ran into this book in a bookstore, Fractals, Form, Chance, and Dimension by Benoit Mandelbrot, and it has to do with the fractal geometry of nature. So I bought the book and took it home and read it, cover to cover, every last little word, including footnotes and references, twice.
In his book, Mandelbrot said that many forms in nature can be described mathematically as fractals, a word he invented to define shapes that look jagged and broken. He said that you can create a fractal by taking a smooth-looking shape and breaking it into pieces over and over again. Carpenter decided he'd try doing that on his computer.
Within 3 days, I was producing pictures of mountains on my computer at work. The method is dead simple. You start with a landscape made out of very rough triangles, big ones. And then for each triangle, break it into four triangles. And then do that again, and again, and again, and again, and again.
Endless repetition. What mathematicians call iteration. It's one of the keys to fractal geometry.
The pictures were stunning. They were just totally stunning. No one has ever seen anything like this. And I just opened a whole new door to the new world of making pictures. And it got the computer graphics community excited about fractals because suddenly they were easy to do. And so people started doing them all over the place.
Carpenter soon left Boeing to join Lucasfilm, where instead of making mountains, he created a whole new planet for Star Trek II: The Wrath of Khan. It was the first ever completely computer-generated sequence in a feature film.
Fascinating.
Made possible by the new mathematics of fractal geometry.